Welcome everyone. My name is Hal Mark. I'm with Stop, Breathe, and Smile. And we're very pleased and proud to be able to bring Christian Das to South Florida again. Thank you guys for showing up. Before we get started, a couple of things. If anybody doesn't know already, the restrooms are on the sides, many of them are on both sides. I'm going to lead off a list of the sponsors that helped create this event. Without the sponsors, systems, this don't happen. So if you can reach out to some of them and support, that'd be great. Momochai, I Love Yoga, Holistic Health Fund, Mindful City, UCloud, Five Sisters, Weston Yoga, Yoga Source, and Animals for Animals. And especially Unity on the Bay for creating this space and making it available. I started back in 1991 here, and it's got me to where I am today, and I'm grateful. Neat place, if you get a chance to come down and check it out. So ladies and gentlemen, Christian Das. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the Littman Theater. My name is Hal Martin. I'm with Stop, Breathe, and Smile. So if we could take a moment just to slow things down a little bit, rushing through traffic to get here. Cover a few things for you, and thank you very much for showing up and supporting our events here. The first thing I'd like to do is I'd like to thank all the volunteers that helped make this possible. We couldn't do it without you. Very grateful for my wife, Marcy, who supports me throughout this. She flew in from Austin at 3 o'clock this afternoon just to be here for this adventure. And Mel Bartel, who is our graphic artist, who's been handling all of our social media. The art that she created on the stage there is quite miraculous, and we're grateful for her. She's up in Toronto. And I want to thank all the sponsors that helped make this possible. We're here because the sponsors are supporting this, so we have to reach out to them and help them out. I have Five Sisters, we have Omachaya, we have UCloud, we have Animals for Animals, we have Western Yoga, Mindful City, long list. And it's on your channel, the bottom of your chance sheet. So if you can kind of hook these people up and check them out, they're the people that are helping make these events happen. So thank you very much. You're not here to listen to me chat. Please welcome.
All right, let's start with some ohms together. Thank you. Vasubhadraga Vasirama Sarachavada Atutamadham Emshalabadeham Anujavana Krishnam Yaninana Vradam Sakalaguna Nadham Anarana Madisham Agupam Oshpati Kripto Aisham Nushiki Kripto Rakshasam Ramaya Mahamalaratnam Vandemilatmajam Anjana Nandarangir Janiki Shokanasham Yesamakshanta Mandilanga Mangam Manojam Marutatulavegam Chitendriya Budhimatam Gavishnam Atapajam Anaritam Lokam Shri Ramadutam Sharanam Prapadhe Shri Ramadutam Sharanam Prapadhe Shri Ramadutam Sharanam Prapadhe Shri Ramadutam Sharanam Prapadhe Kala Bhajanam Gavale Hanuman Ki Jai
Jai Jai Ram.
say through the repetition of these names, gradually but inevitably, this presence is uncovered within us. Uncovered within us. You see, it's within us already. It's not outside of us anymore. It's who we are, and that's inside. Already here. You know, and also just think about it. If you repeat something over and over again, you kind of start to take the shape of that thing, right? So let's say, you know, you're repeating, oh, my baby left me and I feel so bad. Repeat that a few million times, you know. Don't ask me what you'll do. It won't be pretty. So, it's kind of like that. Through these repetitions, the mind starts to take the shape of these names, of these sounds. And when that happens, it's like a lake when the winds calm down, right? And then what's reflected on that lake is clear without any ripple or any distortion. So as the mind calms down, as the thoughts calm down, as we move in, the mirror of our mind or the lake of our mind, it starts to reflect what's really in there, the beauty that's in there, underneath all the stuff we think about ourselves. So that's how this practice works. And if you do it enough, something begins to happen that we really aren't prepared for. Really. We don't expect it, we don't have to deal with it, and it's a big problem, and that is, we get happy. Big problem, right? I mean, face it, we spend all our time trying to get the stuff that makes us happy and get rid of the stuff that makes us unhappy. What do you do when you wake up in the morning? You're already happy. The whole day is ruined. I'm waiting for a few of those days, you know? So when we do this practice, the way I share this with people is very simple. You sing, and as soon as you notice you're thinking about something, anything, even like, this is so goddamn boring, how long is it going to go on? Even that, you let it go and you just come back to the singing. Because the doors are locked. That was a long time ago, something else. You just let go of that thought and you come back to the chanting. And this gradually trains us to be able to let go of the thoughts and emotions that really cause us trouble, that cause us pain and unhappiness. It's a practice, they call it, it's a spiritual practice, and it trains us to be able to move more deeply in ourselves.
Thank you.
People ask me a lot more how I learned to chant. Very short answer. I didn't. I just started singing. Nobody told me how, nobody told me what was right or wrong, so I just sang. Of course, I used to sing in India. In the old days, I used to sing along with the kirtanwalas in the temple. And, you know, there was one group of them that I really loved to hang out with. They were just fantastic to sing with, to chant with. There were three of them. And the leader of the group played harmonium, and he would sing the first line. Then the drummer sat over there, he would sing the second line. Then the cymbal player sat over here, and he would sing the third, the second response. So I used to sit next to him, and I played cymbals, and I listened to him very carefully, right? So I could kind of mimic him as he was singing, because some of these melodies are from outer space. They're really hard melodies. And also, you know, when I wake up in the morning, my voice is down here. And by the course of the day, it kind of rises up where human beings can hear it. But these guys, they start about here, and they go up from there. And it's really hard for me to sing along with them, you know. But anyhow, so one day, the harmonium player starts a new melody. We've been singing for a couple of hours, going around and around circling. So he started a new melody. I had never heard it, and it was so difficult. And it started up about here. It was like, I just went, oh my God, what am I going to do, right? So we went around a few times, and I really listened to my buddy over here, the other cymbal player. And I was thinking, so I had my eyes closed, and I didn't see that my buddy got up to go take a piss. So he's, the leader sang, then the other guy sang, then it was our turn. I went, hurry! And I realized I was all alone, you know? But I had to keep going. Hurry! Now this guy, harmonium player, he didn't like me. He never looked at me. He never talked to me. He looked like a truck driver with an attitude, and he didn't want to know me at all. But the other guys were really friendly. But anyhow, after this moment, all of a sudden he looked over at me and he goes, nice. The good Kirtanwala's seal of approval. So this is one of the melodies I learned from those guys. And it's actually on the one track part, the first. Also on the new CD, it's funny thing. Rob, they were in it. I knew I'd get it. I first heard this when I was living in India in Great Island. I had a room in a little guest house which had a window right on the street, you know. Every morning at 4 a.m, this blind sadhu would make his way down the street to go, he was going to see, going to have darshan at the temple. He's going to take darshan means sight, so he's going to visit the temples. And he used to have these two shakers, and he would sing as he went by every morning at 4 o'clock. Did you get that part of it? Every morning at 4 o'clock? So I have never forgotten this, especially when I wake up. However, something you don't forget, you know. So Radhe Govinda will see this. Thank you. same India. Take it easy.